In Article 1, we deal with the first evil, which the framers wished to guard against, that is, cases in which a president corruptly misused the power otherwise bestowed on him to secure a personal reward. Guarding against a president who undertakes official acts with the corrupt motive of helping himself is at the heart of the impeachment power. As one scholar explained, the president's duty to faithfully execute the law requires that he undertakes actions only when motivated in the public interest rather than in their private self-interest. Efforts to withhold official acts for personal gain countermand the president's sacred oath and therefore constitute impeachable behavior as it was conceived of by the framers. In Article 2, we also deal with a second evil contemplated by the founders, who made it clear that the president ought not operate beyond the limits placed on him by legislative and judicial branches. Impeachment was warranted for a president who usurped the power of the Constitution that was not granted to him, such as to deny Congress the right to determine the propriety, the scope, and the nature of an impeachment inquiry into his own misconduct. The framers fashioned a powerful chief executive, but not one beyond accountability of law. When a president wields power in ways that are inappropriate and seek to extinguish the rights of the Congress, he exceeds the power of his constitutional authority and violates the limits placed on his conduct. Obstruction of a separate and co-equal branch of government for the purposes of covering up an abuse of power not only implies a corrupt intent, but also demonstrates a remarkable antipathy towards the balance of power contemplated and enshrined in our Constitution. It is a betrayal of the president's sacred oath of office and of his duty to put the country before himself.